Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.1 Developer Beta 3. Now, it's out for developers at the time of this video, but it will be out to public beta testers very soon, either the same day, later on, or the following day. Now, it was a pretty exciting day for Apple. They announced new iPhones along with iOS 13.1 GM or Golden Master. That's been released, and it's kind of difficult to upgrade to or downgrade to depending on what version you're on. If you'd like to know how to do that, I've linked a separate video in the description below if you want to check that out. Now, the other thing is iOS 13.1 actually comes out on September 30th. Apple announced that today, and it also comes out at the same time as iPadOS. So iOS 13.1 and iPadOS come out on September 30th. So you're better off just staying on the 13.1 betas if you're already on it. Otherwise, it's a little bit difficult to go to the GM of iOS 13. Now, this beta came in at 285.2 megabytes on my iPhone XS Max. Let's take a look at the build number, performance, battery life, and any new features that we might have. This build is 17A5837A, and that A means we're very close to the final, but we already know that. This is coming out on September 30th, so we can expect a couple more betas until that final release. Now, in this particular beta, there are 27 known issues, and there is only one resolved issue, at least mentioned in the notes. That doesn't mean they haven't fixed other bugs as well. There's also a modem update as well, so if you're still having issues with connectivity like I am, I really don't have connectivity issues unless I leave Wi-Fi. If I leave a Wi-Fi network, I actually have to turn on airplane mode, turn it off, turn off my Wi-Fi network, and then it works fine. Now, it doesn't seem to matter the carrier, it just seems to be the Intel-based devices. So it's kind of strange, but I've had a lot of complaints from many of you telling me you have the same issue. Now, there's only one small little change that they've shown here so far that I've found, and that's the Apple TV app has been updated with a new icon. It's black and white now. And also, Apple announced today Apple TV Plus, which is coming out on November 1st. So that will be $4.99 per month. And if you get a new iPhone or a new iPad this year, you get a year free with it. So it's actually a pretty good deal. Who knows how many things there will be to watch, but that's a pretty good deal. Now, aside from that, the good thing is with 13.1, we still have Siri automations where iOS 13 GM does not have it. So I would suggest staying on 13.1. Now, also, the announce message with Siri is not there. So if we go to Siri and search, it's just not there anymore. So hopefully they bring this back by the final release, but currently it's not there. There's also no new emojis yet. I would expect those by the final release. Google actually already pushed them out with Android 10, so I'm surprised we haven't seen them with iPhone, but maybe they'll be in the final version. Now, the good thing is, for those of you having issues with mail seems to have no issues right now, at least in the past hour or two. Also, iMessage seems to be fixed, so any of the bugs you've reported, those seem to be fixed as well. Performance is quite good. 3D touch is good, although 3D touch is basically haptic touch now. Now, on the new iPhones, there is no 3D touch, so that's seemingly why they changed it. But on the older devices, they get most of the features of 3D touch anyway. You just don't get the feeling of it. So they've basically moved it to haptic touch. So it works good not only on the iPhone SE, but also the oldest iPad Air 2. Everything seems to be much more stable. And again, we have less than 30 days to see the final version, so everything's working well. These folders may seem a little bit darker, but I don't really see anything new in them. So performance is great. Now, as far as battery life goes, battery life is pretty good on the previous beta. It's not amazing or anything. It's what I'd expect. I have 100% battery health on this device, but you'll see over the last 10 days, 4 hours and 40 minutes with about 20% left, maybe 10%. So 5.5 hours, it's not great. Hopefully it gets better when the final releases, but it is a beta, so I don't really expect amazing battery life. However, if you haven't heard or watched any other videos on it, the iPhone 11 Pro Max gets 5 hours more than the XS Max, or up to 5 hours more of battery life. So that's pretty impressive. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores for all of you that are interested. So you'll see on the iPhone XS Max, It has a single core of 4,823 and a multi-core score of 10,488. Now, keep in mind, this is the older version of Geekbench. I'm only using it for consistency, but if we take a look at the CPU compared to the previous ones, it's actually gone down quite a bit, but I did run this early on, so it probably will improve greatly once I actually run it again. Now let's take a look at it on the other devices as well. Now on the left, we have the iPad Air 2. In the middle, I have the iPhone SE, and then on the right, I have the XS Max. So this should give you a general idea what you're getting. I would expect a little bit higher. Normally after using the betas for a while, the scores go up. So overall, they're pretty good. So that's it for iOS 13.1 Developer Beta 3. If you found anything I didn't mention that's pretty significant, I'd love to hear what you have to say in the comments below. And also, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.